Hey guys, this is John. Just thought I'd give you another update from London. So it is Thursday. I've been here a week and a half already, and four rounds have gone by in the tournament since I last updated you. Oh, and by the way, it is about 50 degrees and overcast, as it seems to be every day here in London. I swear I haven't seen the sun once since I've been here. So four rounds have gone by in the tournament, like I said, rounds 4 through 7. In round 4, I played Grandmaster Hrant Melkumyan from Armenia, FIDE rating of 2633. Very good player, seems to be solid. I think he lives in Germany. And in that game, he surprised me a little bit in the opening, actually a lot. He played the King's Indian defense. I was white. And that's an opening that I had only seen him play once before. I think out of 500 plus games with black I found in the database of his, he had played it exactly one time. I was expecting a Grunfeld or maybe a Slav in that game. And in tournaments, getting your opponent out of their preparation is so important because you do have so long to prepare for the game. I mean, you almost have an entire day to prepare. So that caught me off guard. I ended up playing the Averbakh variation, which is Bishop E2 and then Bishop to G5. White delays, Knight F3. And we got into an original position. I didn't quite know what I was doing, but structurally the position turned out well for me. Black had this backward D6 pawn. However, he compensated that with a lot of activity. And the game got pretty sharp. There was a moment where he sacrificed his bishop and on h3, and it was not correct for me to take it right away, which I did not. I passed it up. However, in the coming play, he played this move king h7, and in that case, it was correct for me to take the bishop, but I had already decided not to do it, so I made a bit of a mistake there. Concretely, taking the bishop works, but I had decided in my head that it wasn't going to work. It looked too risky. It was going to open my king, so I passed it up. Turns out, though, upon computer analysis, and actually just human analysis after the game, I could have taken it and ran away with my king to the center, and I would have had a winning position from the looks of it. So instead, I opted to trade queens, and we went into an endgame where I was slightly better. I actually won a pawn, but I was not able to win the game. He put up pretty tenacious defense, and even though I had an extra pawn on the king side, I wasn't able to make use of it. But overall, not a bad game, solid draw. And the game after that, I was paired down against another Armenian player. I was playing David Mirzoyan. I think he's like 16 years old, FIDE rating of 2299. And I was black in that game. This time I was able to surprise my opponent. So I played a Slav, but instead of the line that he was probably anticipating, which was the line with Bishop F5 in the slow Slav, I played Bishop G4, just a little twist on things. And it worked out well. I got a good position out of the opening and played a nice middle game too. Ended up netting a pawn. However, I think I'm missing some concrete chances in this tournament because on move 34, I could have capitalized on my advantage and really laid the hammer down. And I played a couple routine moves in a row. I played this move Rook D8 and then Rook A to A8. And I let him off the hook a little bit. I think even after that, I had some chances on move 38. Play was getting sharp right around time control, which is on move 40. But I didn't capitalize. I maintained my one pawn advantage, but he got a bunch of activity with his rook and his bishop and e-pawn. And actually in the final position, I think I'm a little fortunate to have a draw because I wasn't able to calculate right before time control what was going on. So drew that game. And in the next game, I played a pretty clean victory on the white side of a King's Indian defense slash English. It's more like an English structure against, ironically, an English player. George O'Toole was his name. I think FIDE rating of 2262. And that was probably my cleanest game from start to finish this tournament. Just got a small edge out of the opening. He played this move B5, which ended up surrendering the bishop pair and also giving him problems on the light squares. And I got the bishop pair, more space, and just squeezed him. At one point, there's this idea E4, E5, which black cannot prevent. And it just leads to disaster for black. So I was very pleased with that game. And so yesterday I played the French Grandmaster, Sebastien Mazet. Hope I'm pronouncing his name correctly. And he and I had played once before in a league game actually in Iceland. And that was a draw. I think that was back in 2013, I wanna say. But he seems to have improved a little bit in the meantime. He's up over 2,600 now. Good player, very theoretically well prepared. I prepped for that game probably the most of any of my games so far, and it was a Sicilian con, my third Sicilian con of the tournament. Sorry, no Scandi yet, guys. Yet, there is still probably one more game I'll play as black, so we'll see. And we got a highly theoretical game, and it actually followed the course of Carlsen versus Anand from one of their world championship games in Sochi in 2014. And it's a line, it's a very interesting line, it's imbalanced, where white has the bishop pair and more space, but structurally black is doing very well, especially on the queen side. And again, all these games are posted in the description below, so hopefully you guys can check them out and you don't have to just listen to me rambling about a game that you can't see. However, upon playing this game, I sort of think that practically speaking, this line is just difficult for black, and he seemed to know what to do. I don't know if he prepped it specifically, but I'm almost certain he had looked at it before, because he was playing pretty fast in the opening. And I was able to gain some space on the king side. I played this idea g5, g4, which did give me some chances to fight back. We traded off all the rooks and got into a bishop and knight for me versus two bishops ending for white. And again, white maintained the space advantage. And it's just a bit awkward for black. It's one of these endings you just have to defend tenaciously for a while. I was slightly worse. Was able to hold for a little bit. But again, this move 34, which actually was the same move that I messed up against David Mirzoyan a couple rounds prior. Move 34, I missed a chance. I played this move knight d7, which stops white's king from coming in. But I should have gone for activity. I should have played on move 34, c5 check, driving white's king forward, king e5, and then knight g4 check, with the idea king takes e6, and then either knight e3 or bishop takes c4 check. And I saw that line in time pressure, but I wasn't able to correctly evaluate it, and I thought that white's f-pawn would give me problems. But turns out I should have gone for that. That was my best attempt, and black is at least equal. Maybe even white has to be a little bit careful. So I went passive with knight d7, perhaps black can find some miracle hold after that, but that was a pretty big lapse, and he was able to infiltrate with his dark square bishop and end up giving me doubled c pawns and winning my a pawn. And even though it was equal material for a while, white just had all the trumps in the position, and I ended up losing. So he played a great game. He put me under sustained pressure. In that game, I really felt the difference in strength between my opponent and I. Like, you can tell he's a seasoned pro and he knew how to apply the pressure. So good game by him. I'm disappointed to have lost, but my goal here is just to play good chess, good, interesting chess. And I think in that game I did succeed. If I had played the c5 check move, I would have been happy with that game because I think I would have held the draw. But hey, those are the breaks. And I gotta work on my time management too. I've been getting in to more time pressure than I would like. You guys know I'm a time trouble addict, and it caught up with me in that game. So, lost that one. So, currently I'm on, what would it be, 4.5 out of 7. So, +2 in the tournament. Not bad. I'm performing at about expectation, maybe a little bit lower. Can't make a GM norm at this point. Even if I had drawn or won last game, it would still have been very tough, if not impossible. So not worried about the GM norm or anything, just again trying to play good games. Today I play a Polish player, FIDE Master, Michal Paterek, I believe is his name. So I've been prepping a little bit for that. Game is in about 2 hours. And I've got something new up my sleeve for this game. We'll see what happens, but hope he doesn't watch this actually. I'm not going to say what it is, but I'm preparing something that previously he may not have seen before. At least in my practice. So we'll see how that goes. 2 rounds left. Today is round 8, tomorrow is round 9, the last round of the tournament. And then I'm back to the US, which I am looking forward to because I have been here for a while. It's been a fun trip, productive trip, lots of chess, but looking forward to sleeping in my own bed and such. So anyways, check out those games. Again, the links are in the description. I've uploaded all of them to Lee Chess. And sorry for the weather here. It's just a little bit depressing, but what can you do? That's the weather, right? I guess that's the London stereotype. So anyways, thank you guys for following my games and for the support. I'll try to give you one more update before I head back to the States, and I hope everyone is doing well. All right, guys. Bye.